a $5 billion makeover, top secret tech, and a touch of patriotic flair. That's the all-new Air Force One. We're talking a queen-sized bed, a Michelin star-level galley, and an Oval Office that'll make you want to run for president. Beyond its opulent features, this aircraft is a fortress, capable of withstanding nuclear blasts and missile threats. It's not merely luxury, it's the epitome of American pride, painted in red, white, and blue. So buckle up for an exclusive journey into the world of the presidential aircraft. But before we begin, we would like you guys to subscribe to the channel, like this video, and hit the notification bell icon so you don't miss out on amazing and entertaining content. The President of the United States has an incredibly hectic schedule, from meeting world leaders across the globe to addressing local constituents in their hometowns. To ensure that the President can move swiftly and safely, and in a manner befitting the office, we have Air Force One at our disposal. This aircraft has served American presidents for decades, and even served as inspiration for a blockbuster Hollywood action film. The call sign Air Force One is now a household name, but as time progresses and technology advances, Air Force One must also evolve. In fact, the old conference room aboard Air Force One has undergone a significant transformation. We've upgraded to a modern and vastly improved version designed to meet the demands of today's presidency. The cost of this transformation? A whopping $5 billion, and the contract was signed by Boeing approximately 2 years ago. The need for this change was evident, as President Trump himself pointed out on ABC's Good Morning America. The previous model was becoming outdated, operating costs were soaring, and it was no longer cost-effective. With a budget of $3.9 billion and a fresh vision in mind, the U.S. Air Force entrusted Boeing with the task of crafting a new Air Force One. So, what does this $5 billion price tag include? The new Air Force One aircraft will exude sleek modernity and receive a complete interior overhaul. Let's start with the presidential office, which can be likened to the Oval Office in the skies. Instead of the traditional fixed design, they've opted out for a modular office. This means that if repairs are needed inside the plane, they can be carried out more easily and swiftly. Cutting-edge technology and high-tech gadgets will be seamlessly integrated into the office, where the vital decisions are often made. Considering that the passengers aboard Air Force One are influential heads of state, it's crucial that the aircraft not only provides transportation, but also entertainment and comfort during critical meetings. To cater to this need, the narrow galleys will undergo a significant transformation, resembling professional restaurant-style kitchens. This new configuration will enable the staff to serve over 2,000 meals, all cooked to order and sourced from the United States. Even the medical bay will receive a modern update, finally bidding farewell to the tables that were supposed to be replaced 3 decades ago. And the latest medical technologies will be incorporated, and an office area will be provided. They will even be equipped to handle emergency surgical procedures if the need arises. Now let's dive into some exciting changes happening inside the presidential bedroom. Those single fold-out beds, they're being replaced with a spacious queen-size bed. Not just that, but there's also a large flat-screen TV and a comfortable sitting area to ensure the president's utmost comfort. Interestingly, this change was something former President Donald Trump was keen on, and it's now becoming a reality. When it comes to security, the new Air Force One won't disappoint. It will still be equipped to withstand a nuclear blast when on the ground, maintain consistent communications with the ground, boast bulletproof windows, and provide defense against surface-to-air missiles. While many of us might have dreamed of escape pods like in the movies, they probably won't make their way onto the VC-25B. This type of 747 is significantly more demanding than a regular commercial jet, requiring substantial upgrades to its generators to provide ample power. In fact, all the electricity on board the aircraft will be generated by spinning turbines connected to the engines. Speaking of engines, the $22 million powerhouses are in for a major upgrade. They'll be adapted to support the latest top-secret communication technology, avionics, defense systems, and much more. So while the President enjoys the comforts of Air Force One, there's a whole world of advanced technology working behind the scenes. But wait, there's even more on the horizon. Air Force One is exploring the possibility of a supersonic version that will serve as the President's aerial command center. This aircraft will soar at speeds 5 times faster than sound itself, ushering in a new era of presidential travel. It boasts a completely revamped bedroom fit for a president, a galley that rivals Michelin-starred restaurants, a modernized Oval Office in the sky, and an arsenal of cutting-edge security features to safeguard the POTUS. But was it President Trump who first identified the need for these changes? Not quite. The government recognized the need for a makeover back in 2009, and they began to search for replacements. Two contenders emerged, the Boeing 747-8 and the Airbus A380. The condition for the contract was simple. The chosen company had to build the planes in the USA. Airbus, however, deemed this financially impractical and chose not to respond to the US Air Force's notice. This left Boeing as the sole contender, and they eagerly seized the opportunity to craft another Air Force One for the POTUS. Initially, the government aimed to complete the project by 2017, with two more planes to follow in 2019 and 2021. After careful consideration of various Boeing jet models, they settled on the 747-8. While it bears a striking resemblance to the existing Air Force One, it's slightly longer. Then, on May 10, 2016, the US Air Force gave Boeing the green light to kickstart the initial designs for the new Air Force One. The initial contract kicked things off with a value of $170 million. Then, on a significant date, July 15, 2016, a second contract came into play. This time, the focus was on system specifications, which encompassed the environmental control system, the aircraft's interior, the electrical and power system, approaches to sustainment and maintenance. A pivotal moment arrived in August of the following year, when Defense One made an announcement that would impact the replacement program's cost. They opted to purchase two pre-made Boeing 747-8s, originally constructed in 2011 for a Russian airline, Aero. These planes found their way to Southern California Logistics Airport in the Mojave Desert after the Russian Airlines bankruptcy. The deal was sealed at the start of 2018 when the White House committed to pay Boeing a sum of $3.9 billion. This financial injection was to transform the two Boeing 747-8s sitting in storage. Essentially, this meant a complete gutting of the interior and equipment, replacing them with components that meet stringent presidential security standards. Boeing was enthusiastic about this endeavor, proclaiming on Twitter, "Boeing is proud to build the next generation of Air Force One, providing American presidents with a flying White House and outstanding value to taxpayers." President Trump, who negotiated this deal on behalf of the American people, claimed to have saved $1.4 billion off the original cost, though this assertion was never officially confirmed. With the new plane on the horizon, there came a change in nomenclature. Transitioning from VC-25A, the new Air Force One would be designated VC-25B. The contract stipulated that these two planes would be delivered in 2024. Meanwhile, the two existing Air Force Ones would find a home in museums, allowing enthusiasts to marvel at their luxurious interiors and advanced avionics. Everything appeared tranquil until President Trump's conversation with George Stephanopoulos on Good Morning America. He revealed that the new Air Force One was already in the design phase, emphasizing that even though he wouldn't get to experience it himself, he was pleased to contribute to future presidents' journeys. Amid these developments, the question arose, would the frame remain a 747? Indeed it would, but former President Donald Trump had one particular alteration in mind. The colors. Instead of the classic white and ultramarine, the new and larger 747-8 would be adorned with the nation's patriotic red, white, and blue. This change marked the end of the iconic livery scheme introduced by Raymond Lowry during the Kennedy administration. As with any significant project, there were skeptics and critics. Congressman Joe Courtney, a member of the White House Armed Services Committee, sought assurance that the interior and exterior changes wouldn't disrupt the aircraft's delivery schedule or affect its weight. Moreover, some observant souls noted that the new Air Force One bore a striking resemblance to Trump's private jet. A BBC article even provided a side-by-side comparison. Notably, the new plane stood out with its larger wingspan and a length of 250 feet compared to the old Air Force One's 231 feet. In a bid to reduce CO2 emissions, the new model would be equipped with 4GE NX2B engines. This adaptation aimed to release 16 tons less carbon dioxide per trip compared to the VC-25A. When it comes to cost, the negotiated price for these two planes tailed up to $3.9 billion, which averages nearly $2 billion per plane. However, certain media outlets raised eyebrows, suggesting that the new planes could ultimately cost American taxpayers a staggering $5 billion. And that's a wrap on this tour of the new Air Force One. If you found this glimpse into the presidential aircraft fascinating, let us know in the comments below. And if you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit that subscribe button and don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.